Woman just got attacked by a wiener. Somebody call the gosh dang police.
I can't laugh this hard. I've had two kids.
All right, here we go. Look at that. Welcome to America, folks. Yummy, yummy, yum, yum, yum.
To Christie's Kitchen Throwback. Now, you know today's guest from Big Time Rush, Storks, and he's kind of a big deal on TikTok, okay? Everybody, please welcome to my kitchen, Stephen Kramer Glickman!
Yeah!
Where'd you go? Where'd you go? Where'd you go? Leave me hanging, buddy.
Oh, hi.
We're doing a thing.
I love it.
This is so exciting. What are we going to make today?
Corn dogs.
Oh, wow.
Do you see why?
Like Carlos used to eat on the show.
Yeah, a lot, right? Was that just one episode or was that like,
nope.
When was the last time you ate a corn dog?
I don't know. What day is it today? I've never made corn dogs. I've only eaten frozen corn dogs or corn dogs that were thrown at me from a car.
Well, what? Okay, so for our corn dog recipe, we've got our hot dogs on standby, we've got our flour, our cornmeal, our granulated sugar, our baking powder, kosher salt, baking soda, and freshly ground black pepper. We also have some cayenne pepper, a cup of buttermilk, two large eggs, and vegetable oil for our fryer. Ketchup and mustard for serving. Are you a cook?
I am one of the worst. my ex-girlfriend asked me once to make dog food for the dogs.
That was a red flag right there.
Yep, she said, go take some of that cooked chicken that's in the fridge. It's like cold chicken. Take that, take some celery, take some carrots,
what?
Throw it in a blender.
What kind of dog do you own?
I don't know, I got a pug. I got a big fat pug named Jelly Donut. She looks like a pillow with eyeballs. I love her very much. And so I go in the kitchen and I pull out the Black & Decker, blender, and I throw it in there, and it's a mess. It's just juices getting out of the chicken juice, and the juice, it's just getting all over, and it's like, it's just broken. It's just all sorts of things are going everywhere. It's nasty.
Yeah.
So I went into the room to talk to her. I go, hey, you're really setting me up to fail here, you know? Like, you asked me to put the chicken and the stuff in the Black & Decker, and she goes, we don't have a Black & Decker blender. We have a Black & Decker juicer. Did you juice the meat? I also tried to make Thanksgiving dinner once and almost burned the house down.
Maybe we could just start with these.
Let's just do this.
Dry ingredients.
How about you make and I eat?
No.
Oh, you're going to show me.
I promise you this is going to be awesome.
What are we going to do?
I don't know if you know this, but when you're combining the batter, it's always good to put the dry ingredients first. So go ahead.
I did not know that.
Help me put these dry ingredients in.
Okay, so this is.
Does it matter, sir? I don't know what all these things are. I don't know the amounts.
High grade.
That's flour.
Okay, flour.
That's flour.
Okay, all right. All right, that's that.
That's cornmeal.
This is cornmeal.
Yes.
Ah, yes. Good old fashioned cornmeal from the farm.
The farm.
Just the way my mother liked it.
How did you start working with Nickelodeon?
Well, I had a meeting with a woman named Sarah Noonan. Now I believe she's the head of talent in general for everything. At the time it was just animation. And so I went in as an animated person and just did like a million voices. Like just do a bunch of different like weird accents. My grandfather like spoke like this. You know, I would just do like all these fun characters for her.
Yeah.
And at the end of the meeting, she said, you're gonna be a part of Nickelodeon for the rest of your life. About a month later, they were trying to cast Big Time Rush.
Uh-huh.
I thought it was animated because it came from Sarah.
Right.
So I walked in a hoodie like this.
Uh-huh.
Like kind of being like, and every other guy in the audition was wearing a suit and tie, very dressy, and they all had gray hair, and I was bald. I went in anyways and like was funny. I did my funny bits, and I said a goodbye to everyone.
Yeah.
And I walked out of the audition. My phone rang, and it was Nickelodeon. And saying, get your back over to the callback. You have a callback right now.
Okay.
And I ran back across the lot at Paramount, did the callback, went home, woke up the next morning, found out that I'd gotten the role, and started shooting Monday and never stopped for 5 years.
Okay. I'm trying to think, do you want to stir or do I want to stir?
You stir.
All right, I'm stirring.
I shouldn't be allowed in the
kitchen.
Actually,
are you sure?
Yeah, I'm pretty bad at life.
Well, there's that.
Okay,
and it happens. You break some eggs around here in Christie's kitchen. You got this. I think
you've got the nice big
hands, and I think you can do this.
I do. Okay. All
get
right.
Get it.
I'm getting in there.
Sometimes it helps us think when we stir.
To say things like that?
I'm getting it. I'm gonna do it right now. Best. This is how man does it. In the kitchen.
So hey, check this out. This batter looks really, really good.
It does. That is beautiful.
This is actually, and you could probably even try it. It's that cornmeal taste that makes it taste like a corn dog. Do you want to try it?
Yeah. Can I?
Go for it. Yeah. It's corn dog batter. Let's get after it. All right, we'll cut.
That's really good.
It's good?
We could make a voice for each hot dog that we do.
I love that. That's what I was thinking.
Like, this is a Russian hot dog. And he's like, I am very excited to be in there. Better? Put me in better, please. I want to get in the better. Go now.
We could make this one like a southern dog. Like, I'm very excited to get in the gosh dang better. Put me in! Put me in, Christy!
I don't want to put you in anywhere. I'm just going to go and sit over here. Oh, wait. Were you going to let me just sit in there?
Get in the gosh dang. Get in the gosh dang. Oh, I swear to God.
Oh, all right.
All right, so you go ahead and put your dog in the batter. So this see what I'm doing? I'm letting the batter kind of like slide down. And then we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna put.
Oh yeah, I see what's happening. All right. Oh, that's real nice.
Let it form a little bit, right?
Oh no, I'm burning in the oil.
I kinda like it, it kinda feels nice. It's like an oil jacuzzi. I always said you never took me anyplace special, Carl.
Well, now we're going on to vacation.
I like it, it feels so tropical.
This is nice. It's like Palm Springs in here.
I like it. Let's swim.
There we go.
My goodness. Don't get fresh. Don't get fresh now.
He's a wild wiener, folks. He's wild. Yeah, you just can't control that wiener. He does what he wants, folks. That wiener just flopping everywhere.
All right, I'm going to control the wiener because it's my show and my kitchen. All right, so we'll keep making a few because these are smaller. And I love that they're smaller because you can have more of them.
Sure.
Smaller foods make you want to eat more. Ow! I think we should cover it.
Woman just got attacked by a wiener. Somebody called the gosh dang police.
I can't laugh this hard. I've had two kids.
All right, here we go. Look at that. Welcome to America, folks.
Look, it's a
really?
Look, it's a bouquet of corn dogs.
A bouquet of corn dogs.
Look how beautiful these are.
It's. There's something there that wasn't there before. I don't remember how that song goes.
You would be an amazing beast.
La 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 la.
So here's your wiener.
Oh, thank you so much.
And here's my wiener. I think my wiener is bigger than yours.
Wow.
We're 10 years old.
This is what happens when Disney and Nick gets together.
Yeah, exactly.
There's a bunch of wiener show-offs. Just showing each other our wiener. She glanced this way, I thought I saw. And when we touch, she didn't shudder at my paw. No, it can't be, I'll just ignore. But then she never looked at me that way before.
New and a bit alarming. Who'd have ever thought that this could be? You ready to eat it?
Yeah, let's eat it.
All right. Aw.
Oh my gosh, that's so good.
That's very good.
That's very, very good.
It's very good. So what are you doing now? Obviously, you've got an amazing TikTok page.
The TikTok page? Yes, I have 1.1 million people on the TikToks at Stephen, S-T-E-P-H-E-N-K Glickman. Stephen K. Glickman. And then on Twitter and Instagram, it's just Stephen Glickman over there. And you can check out my podcast, which is super fun. And I would love to have you on.
I would love to be on your podcast.
It's
done.
We'll make it happen. The show is called The Nighttime Show, and you can check it out anywhere podcasts can be found. And
your shirt's at Hot Topic.
My shirts are at Hot Topic.
Link below.
And you know what? I have not mentioned this anywhere really yet, except told a few friends here and there. But I will tell you, I'm recording my first album, a music album of covers and songs.
Ooh.
And working with a whole bunch of different really wonderful producers from Disney and Nickelodeon shows that are producing the album for me. So
that's very cool. If you guys can guess how many times we said the word wiener in this video. Because it's, very serious business here.
It's a very serious wiener business. And we did say wiener a lot.
Wiener.
Yeah. So if you can guess how many times we said the word wiener on the show, The top five people are gonna win the Golden Glickman shirt from Hot Topic. So all you gotta do is let us know in the comments how many wieners there are in this episode.
Wiener. High fives. We did it. Would you like to take your wiener?
I sure
would. Okay, get out of here.
Bye.
Bye, Glickman. I love you.
Love you.
Love him. Guys, subscribe. This is the most amazing channel on YouTube. And I just love you guys. So yeah, subscribe. I'm out.